What's the difference between Windows 10 and Windows 11? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. You know, this might seem like a really odd question to ask right now. After all, Windows 11 has been out for, well, several years now. However, with the impending end of Windows 10 support, and with its still large installed base, and with Windows 11 being a somewhat moving target, the question is actually more relevant than ever. If you've got Windows 10 and are considering Windows 11, what's the difference? Let's compare and contrast and complain just a little. Now, I do want to point out that this isn't going to be a really deep technical explanation of the differences between the two operating systems. There are plenty of places for that. And honestly, the average user, the average consumer, the average Windows user, you don't care about any of that. You don't need to know any of that. So, with that little caveat out of the way, let's talk about what I've referred to as the elephant in the motherboard, the hardware requirement. By far, the most controversial difference is Windows 11's new security-related hardware requirements. That includes Trusted Platform Module version 2, TPM, a UEFI, Secure Boot Capable, which replaces a traditional BIOS that we've used in previous machines, and a compatible 64-bit processor. So some other baseline requirements have changed as well. There's no 32-bit version. Minimum RAM requirements have increased from 2 to 4 gigabytes. Minimum disk space has increased from 20 gigabytes to 64 gigabytes. DirectX 12 graphics device driver software is required. It was previously DirectX 9. And the minimum screen resolution is now 1280 by 720, which is an increase from the old 800 by 600. Now, this latter set of other baseline requirements, that kind of a change is actually pretty traditional from one version of Windows to another, heck, one version of an operating system to another. It's the restrictions imposed by that first list, however, most specifically the CPU requirement and the TPM requirement, that has generated a fair amount of controversy since they actually preclude many existing older machines from running Windows 11. All right, once you fire up Windows 11 for the first time, you'll notice that it looks a little different. Another controversial, though perhaps less impactful change, is that the Start menu is, by default, in the middle of the taskbar. Now, you can move it to the left if you want to, but the taskbar itself can't be placed anywhere other than the bottom. Unlike Windows 10 and previous versions, where you could stick it to the side, the bottom, the top, the left, the right, wherever you wanted. Can't do that anymore. There are also a number of what I would refer to as traditional changes, the kinds of things that change with every Windows version. For example, there's some cosmetic changes. Rounded corners are back, apparently. Softer colors, new animations, transparency effects, and so forth. Now, there are a selection of other differences that I've culled from the Microsoft Windows 11 specifications page. Again, I've culled them to focus on the kinds of things that an average user, a real person, might notice or potentially even care about. For example, Cortana, the app, is gone. Actually, she's been gone for a while. Microsoft Edge with IE mode replaces Internet Explorer 11. Mail, calendar, and people have been replaced with the new Outlook. S mode is only available for Windows Home Edition. Honestly, I'd avoid S mode anyway. Windows 11 does not support disabling the return of internet search results when you search. Named groups and folders of apps are no longer supported in the Start menu, and the layout of the Start menu is not resizable. In that same vein, live tiles, things that you could put in the Start menu that would do things, they're gone. Tablet mode is gone. The wallet is removed. The Mixed Reality Portal app, the Windows Mixed Reality for Steam VR and Steam VR Beta, all gone. WordPad is removed. This one kind of hurts. Widgets are added. Passkeys are added natively to Windows Hello. There are security additions, such as what I would refer to as reputation-based installation blocks. Microsoft calls it Smart Screen. They've been added or improved. And application interfaces have some changes, the most notable being that Windows File Explorer has a new look and feel to it. Snipping tool has kind of changed and consumed some of the other snip-related tools, and so forth. The full list is somewhat longer and occasionally very esoteric, but you can find it on the Microsoft website. The article for this video will have links to exactly that. The items above, like I said, they represent what I feel most average users might actually notice or care about. Now, under the hood, there are many changes under the hood that don't necessarily change how you see or interact with Windows 11, but rather they are intended to perform its overall performance and or security. Many of these changes, interestingly enough, are positioned specifically as relating to gaming, gaming interaction, and gaming performance. It's unclear whether the improvement impacts non-gaming activities. My expectation is that while some might, many will not. I will tell you that my experience using both Windows 10 and Windows 11, performance appears similar for non-gaming tasks. Other changes like so-called virtualization-based security, kernel DMA protection, and others do represent additional security protections. I've also seen claims that Windows 11 has made an assortment of changes to improve both boot time and the performance of applications currently being used, in other words, what we would call your foreground applications. Much like the gaming improvements, it's unclear if these improvements are things you'll even notice. I haven't. Now, there's a set of complaints that get bundled into complaining about Windows 11, but they're not really Windows. Certainly, they're from Microsoft, and they might be interwoven into Windows, maybe even more tightly than we want, but they are separate from Windows. By those, I mean OneDrive, Edge, Office, Office 365, Microsoft 365, Microsoft 365 Copilot, whatever they call it next week, Outlook and Outlook New, Copilot itself, though this integration is actually getting tighter every day. So the line here is definitely blurring, particularly with what are called Copilot Plus PCs. What happens to this set of features, though, is independent of Windows itself. What I mean by that is that there's a very good chance you'll experience some of their changes and updates, regardless of which version of Windows you're actually running. My take on Windows 11 has been pretty simple from the start. Honestly, it's less a major new version of Windows and just a substantial upgrade. It's something that in years past we might have simply called a service pack. I suspect that the change in hardware requirements, more than anything else, is what drove Microsoft to actually call this Windows 11 rather than something like Windows 10 Service Pack 1. I say that to make this point. Windows 11 isn't that huge a leap from Windows 10. While it looks a little different at times, it's just Windows. And while there are differences, to be sure, as long as your machine is capable, the differences are manageable and honestly not really that difficult to get used to. The biggest difference of all might simply be this. While it will certainly keep working, Windows 10 stops being officially supported in October of 2025. While there's no official final end of support date for Windows 11, it's going to be supported for many years to come. I've got a question for you, and I'll ask you to leave this in the comments below. If you're already using Windows 11 after having used Windows 10, which changes did you notice the most? Remember, try and focus on changes in Windows, not OneDrive, not Office, not the other stuff that isn't Windows, Windows itself. What impacted you the most? Obviously, I've selected the changes that I think most people will care about, but your experiences will help other people decide as well. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/178677. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.